Hello, and welcome back to a Game of Thrones mod for Crusader Kings 2. Last time we set up all the courtiers, and I've set them all as special interest now, so we should get pop-ups about weird stuff happening to them, or say, if they randomly get murdered by their husband. Don't know who that could have happened to. But yes, they're all set up here, and we do have an open bodyguard position now, I suppose. We have two. So, let's put some people in. We're looking for High Marshal. I'm going to put in... Wait, did somebody else die? Because I'm sure we shouldn't have two open bodyguard positions. If somebody else died, please tell me, because I didn't notice it, but, you know, that's fine. We're going to put in Justin as our bodyguard. And we're also going to put in Brandon as our bodyguard. There we go. We've got a lot of bodyguards. Seems to be doing fine. Should we get this reaving done? We've been reaving for a very long time. I kind of thought it's been reaving long enough that makes me think that maybe there's a way to just stop reaving, but it seems like we just keep going forever, which is fine. The enemy merchants were too well armed for us to take their gold. They utilized their warships to good effect, not allowing us to board their vessels. We lost a few men, but we shall take. We lost a few men, but we shall be back to take our iron price. There is always the next raid. Yeah. Yeah, we're doing a lot of raiding. People have arrived in Pyke. Rhaegal offers to teach you a game called Saivassi that he learned from some merchants in the inn. I mean, I suppose we could. Yeah, I'd be delighted to test my wits in this game. You think you're starting to get the hang of Saivassi. Rhaegal wants to challenge you to a game. Yes. We're not very deceitful, so we won't try and pay a young girl to distract him and ensure we win. We'll just play circles around him. Of course we'll win. Probably drinking quite a lot this time. You should have known better to play Cervace against the man who taught you everything you know. Rhaegal crushed you completely. I suppose that's in keeping with his deceitful and manipulating nature. Now, let's see, which option would we go for? Would we kick the table or would we say it was a good game? We'd probably say it's a good game. We're not too... We're not the kind of person who's going to be getting too annoyed at, like, just losing a game. So we'll do that. Did we become temperate? We did not become temperate. Okay, cool. Well, what's Aegon actually up to right now? We got a whole bunch of stuff. But what's Aegon actually up to right now before we check that? Who's he at war with? He's just at war with the North? He's got no other conquests going on? Oh, interesting. No more dragon does he still have a dragon? He still has a dragon, yeah. So he could still continue his dragon conquests. Ironborn longships cut through the water swift and sure. Hence we have successfully pursued a small merchant ship. Yes, let's attack it. The reaving party has been roving on the coast, but the local patrol has spotted us and is attacking. Being Ironborn, we will of course meet this challenge, but the leader of the band stands before me with what one thought to kill me. Well, let's charge. A duel will ensue for the local master of arms. You and Sebastian. Oh yeah. Also, as many people pointed out, this is not Slaver's Bay. This is Slaver's Bay. This is Disputed Lands, apparently, is what I've been told. Right. You and Sebastian slowly circle each other, tense and focused. You scan him for any sign of weakness, any opening in his defense you could possibly exploit. Now, this is actually a new system that we get three options and I have absolutely no idea which one we want to go for. It's a new duel system they put in this patch. So maybe we'll try he's no match for my might because we're like really tall. Wait, did I mean to put... I guess giant is the name of the trait. It is still tall. We're a berserker. You know, this seems like the kind of thing we do. We just try and overpower him. We're strong. He's no match for my might. Use great range of your sword to great effect. Uther cannot get close enough to strike. Eventually you see a weak spot. Bring down your weapon from a great height upon him. Strike. Easily break through Uther's guard and knock him to the ground. He lies sprawled at your feet, completely at your mercy. It's all over now. Uther drops his weapon, throws up his hands. Yield! I yield. Unfortunately, we've gone into a frenzy. So he will die. Uther crumples to the ground. Wait, what? Why is he dead? What? That wasn't who I was fighting. I was fighting Sebastian, right? apologies, I guess. I didn't read the event fully on the end one. We were fighting Sebastian. But, oh. Goodbye, Uther. It was nice knowing you. Ugh. The merchants were too well armed for us to take the gold. They utilized the warships to good effect, not allowing us to board the merchant vessels. Lost a few men, but we shall be back to take our arm price. Yes. This reaving is really a bad idea. During the attack, Aegir Rivers was wounded by an enemy fighter, but like true Ironborn, he's chosen to stay with our band of reavers. Okay, cool. Good man. Good man. Right. A whole bunch of stuff's happening. In this past month, your captain of the fleet, Lord James Ironfoot, has been organizing a reaving. A reaving he has announced he will target the seas of the disputed lands. He and his fellow reavers are now ready. They've set sail from Salt Cliff on their quest to follow the old way. Do us proud. Alright, so James, Mayford, and Ethan. And Justin went. Interesting. That's cool. So he's taken a few of the other people who didn't get to go on this reaving away. There's now a non-aggression pact between Manfred Hightower and Myrne Gardner. Good, good. Lord Muford of Starfield accepted King Lauren of the Rock's peace offer, so that's the civil war over there. Justicar Lannis is doing a superb job. I'm having trouble with a town and a castle in Saltcliff, and I shall, of course, send my Justicar Lannis to try and increase the relation between us and them, but which one should I start with? Well, obviously the castle, because we don't have a town, but, you know. Not being picky and just saying we don't have a town. The reaving has come to an end. We have returned from across the seas after abiding the old way of reaving and pillaging like true Ironborn. We have gained much respect for our daring and ambition. We are true Ironborn. We lose the trait reaving and everyone gets an opinion bonus because we went reaving. Yeah. And the regency ended. Did we get like the trait for reaving? Like reaver? No. I don't think it's the actual trait. Yeah. I think I saw some people saying they wanted to be a reaver, but I don't think it's a trait. Unless it is, and you just need to actually succeed at your reaving. Like, properly. I don't know. Oh, we've got another minor title. Why do we have another bodyguard position? Oh, we have another bodyguard position because one of our bodyguards went off reaving. Yeah, that makes sense, I think. None of them died, right? Yes. Oh, wait, no, we have one because Uther died because I killed him by accident. Yeah. I guess we'll have Lenzi as one of our bodyguards. Right, what do we want to do now? We just came back from raiding. That was some fun. We spent a lot of time out raiding, reaving. I'm still trying to figure out what's up with Aegon's conquest. He appears to have kind of slowed it down. Maybe because he's already at war with the North, it doesn't trigger it doesn't trigger the conquest event until he's done with that war. Possibly. Now, what do we actually want to be doing? Like, I'm trying to think of, like, a goal for us right now. I think just continued raiding seems like a good goal for us. Do you want to maybe fabricate claims? That doesn't seem like a thing that we would do very much. Yeah, we're kind of fine where we are for just now. Let's start fabricating some claims. Not fabricating some claims. Let's start getting a raid going. So, who's at... So if the North is at war with Aegon, what might be a good idea is to go and raid the North a little bit. So let's raise up our troops, raise up our boats, and we'll get the troops on the boats. Need to find the right hotkey. And we'll just kind of head straight up. Wait, why are we hostile to Aegon? Oh, I didn't set this group to slaughter. I just realized that we were hostile to Aegon's forces there. A daughter was born to Maelys Blackfyre and Winifred, named Lenia. We have Lenia Blackfyre, who is also ugly. Okay, fair enough. Wait, can I toggle looter here? No, I need to be in a province owned by me. There we go. Toggle looter. Get on boat. Now we'll head to the north. Yeah, we're hostile to Aegon. Why? Hostile to Uris. Due to being raided. Alright, yeah, that's fair enough. We did raid him. That is very fair. Drop our men on Flint's Cliffs. We want Rico and we only have one leader. So Recaro can be the only leader. Well, yeah, that's fine. We'll have him leading for just now. Let's switch it to this view so we can just see how much we're skimming. It's not a lot, but it's fine. My lord, it's come to my attention. Nobody has been designated regent for Saltcliff should the realm need it. Needless to say, this is a perilous position, as surely squabble and rivalry will emerge without clear leadership. I humbly petition you name me as designated regent to avoid a sort of trouble. Signed, Aegir of House Rivers. Well, we're very trusting. We're you know, we're open to ideas. We've probably been drinking. Yeah, sure, you can be regent. I see no problem with that. I in no way think you murdered your wife. Right, so let's go back on the boats. My young courtier has finished her education in the ways of the court and statesmanship. It turned out less well than expected, so that beat Fernie, who is married to Ronald Esterman. Oh well. Let's jump back on here, head over to Cape Kraken. We're not getting a lot of money from the north. There's not a lot of loot to actually get here, but we'll grab what we can. A daughter was born to Rakaro and Talia named Rogi. Okay, cool. Grab our money and run away. Arryn the Black has declared Harren Hor's outlaw's invasion of Winter's Keep on Chief Len of Central Flossfax. Okay, so he has become head of a set of he's become head of a group of outlaws. He's now a wildling and a deserter. So he went to Night's Watch, deserted, joined the wildlings, went to has now declared an invasion of Winter's Keep, which is one of the provinces up here somewhere. Wait, unless it's on a night. Is that a province in the Night's Watch? I don't think it is. Yeah, on Chief Len. Alright, oh, it's this province right here. I think. Or one that. Well, oh, it's this one. Right, found it at last. Yes. That's interesting. Harren's definitely not a boring character. Mern has declared the Reachman Westerosi War of Emancipation on King Aegon of Westeros. Well, fair enough, fair enough. How much money can we hold? We can hold 120 and we're getting like 2 ducats, I think. Flint's Finger. Do I see any provinces over here? Oh, right, the ones a little bit further in are worth some more money. We can't kind of jump in here. Yeah, let's head to Barrowtown. Definitely. Let's leave Barrowtown as soon as possible. Spearmouth seems a lot better. King Torrhen of the North accepted King Aegon of Westeros' peace offer. Yeah, fair enough. Kind of expected him to. Grab a little bit of money, grab a little bit of money. The moment we see anybody else appearing, we'll run away. A son was born to Dynald Fire and Talia named Ordello. Ordello Fire is a twin. Oh, there's also a Tormo. Fire. Cool. Lord Urrus, the finances of the realm are in a poor state. Pike is in urgent need of gold, so I hereby request you provide a loan for House Greyjoy. Regards, Lord Reaver Victrin of House Greyjoy. Now, we're not greedy, are we? No. I think we'll just accept. We'll just do what he says. We're very accepting. A daughter was born to Manfred Mac and falsely named Fernie. Okay, nothing special about her. Oh, out of here. Get out of here. Fate smiles upon me. My wife Arwen is pregnant. Great. Let's get out of here with our money. We got 9 ducats. It's a glorious day. Who's at war now? The Crossing, are you at war? You're at war in the Reachman's War of Emancipation. Ooh, the Reach are at war. We can maybe sneak in here. If we could get to Highgarden, there's a lot of money. Like, we can travel major rivers, I think. Where's our navy? Oh, there it is. Our fleet, I should say. Right, we'll keep following it down. Now, can we go in major rivers? We can. Great. That's exactly where I want to head, so that we can just quickly send our men into Highgarden. Most thought James Ironfoot's raid upon the village would be simple, but those men who so were more hardy than they thought. The Ironborn managed to make a beachhead, but were fought back. They failed to claim their iron price today. Oh. Can we go reaving again, by the way? Wait, how did that arm... How was that army already there? That army was not there a second ago. I guess we just walked into them. Like, we had fog of war and just walked into them. That's something to watch out for, actually. Well, our army's gone. Let's head back home with our money. That's fine. Yeah, the Fog of War has messed me up a little bit, but that's fine. To the affable Berserker Urus, peace be with you. We've decided to offer you the position of commander. Sure. I'll happily be your commander. A son was born to Warwick Westford and Tulsi named Tulwi. He's a genius. Okay. Yeah, we brought back 9 gold. Our boats probably cost more. Yeah, we currently don't have much of a levy, so we'll just wait for that to replenish a little bit. Urus Serpentail, invite you to pay the iron price by joining me on a reaving to the far north in the Shivering Sea. We can target Lothrathi and Ibony ships. I promise that we will gain many salt wives, much plunder, as in the ways of old. Yours, Aegir Rivers. Yeah, sure, I'll join you. Definitely. Oh, wait. And he has been appointed my regent. That doesn't seem right. Visenya of Queen Visenya's host has declared Visenya's conquest of Case on King Lauren of the Reach. Of the Rock, sorry. Of Case. That's a single province. I'm not entirely sure that's what you wanted to do, but fine. Lots of fun stuff's happening. Oh, yep. It changed. We now have Warwick Westford is now our... he is now our regent. Because, of course, Aegir was going off on this adventure as well. Harren the Black has taken some land above the wall. Interesting. So does he control all of this now? Yeah, he controls the central Frostfangs. He is definitely powerful. Aegir Rivers fearlessly decided to attack a merchant flotilla, but the enemy crews were no match for the Ironborn. We sank their pearly mad escorts, seized their cargo, and slew or took captive many men. This is why we follow the old way. Victory. Fantastic. During the attack, Justin Benson was wounded by an enemy fighter, but like a true Ironborn, he has chosen to stay with our band of Reavers. Oh, good. Oh, there's the Reaver trait. Yeah. Yeah, cool. I knew it existed somewhere. Aegir Rivers is now known as the Warrior. The pillaging and looting undertaken in your name has earned you a reputation as a fearsome Ironborn raider. Along the coast of Westeros, mothers tucking their children in at night warn that unless they behave, the terrible Urus, Scourge of the Seas, will come ashore with his undead warriors and eat them. I like the sound of that. Yeah. Perfect. I wish I knew what that trait's internal name was, but that's fine. We can sort it out later. And Nymor Martell died after a period of illness. He was just kind of related. He was a child of Princess Meria. After a hard day reaving, the men are having many a strong drink while we anchor. Another reaver is bragging of the many men he has killed this day and how he's the boldest of the Ironborn there. My companions think I should challenge him to a finger dance to prove otherwise. Well, of course I'll challenge Lord James to a finger dance. After accepting the challenge, James Ironfoot and I had a finger dance. We both artfully dogged and bravely caught many an axe, but only suffered trifling injuries. All agreed it was a good lark. Oh good, we only have a very small chance of being completely maimed. Yes, and that's the other side of it, because of course we have James' special interest. We did not die. Good. Aegir Rivers' decision to attack a merchant's fleet was sound. The fleet was fairly well defended. We lost a few men seizing their ships, as well as some damage to our long ships. But yeah, no one can resist the Ironborn Reavers, and much cargo and captives were taken. It turns out that if you're not an idiot, these raids do a lot better. Great. There's now a wildling revolt on Harren the Black. Aegir Rivers' decision to attack a merchant fleet was once again sound, and we took much cargo and many captives. Although we don't appear to actually be getting any captives, I wonder how that works, or whether that the reaving things are just purely nice events. Oh, there's now another wildling revolt against Harren the Black. Cool. Oh, we have a daughter. We will, of course, go for the name it's given us, Ysilia. So, oh, and we need to choose a focus for her. Well, as she's our daughter, she will probably be focused. She will probably be chosen by people in our court somehow. Counselors and other courtiers. Yes. Cool. Build the ambition to have a daughter. Need to pick an ambition. Our next ambition. Have many children. Possibly. That's not outside the realm of possibility. War chest, honorary title, You know what? I think we'd like to have many children now. Yes. That seems to work out for me. Oh, it's auto-saving. Betrothed can marry. Fantastic. Jonel can marry Lannis. That can go through. Aegir River's decision to attack Fishing Village produced a fight that was hard fought and a few of her men were lost, but none can withstand the might of the Ironborn, who had claimed the Iron Price today, winning or plunder from those weak people. Yeah. Perfect. They got married, and I think this is a good point to end the episode. Thank you for watching. Yeah. Join us quite a lot. See you next time. Goodbye.